Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to today's webinar on MIDAS Gen and Design Plus updates. This is Rohan Agarwal from MIDAS IT and I'm working as a structural engineer in the technical support team. Our content for the day includes the updates in MIDAS Gen from 2018 to our latest 2021 version, followed by updates in Design Plus. Let us directly jump to the updates now. Beginning with plate forces. Plate forces are displayed in the local axis of the plates. In MIDAS, local axis can now be aligned by providing a beta angle or a reference vector either during creation of the plates or it could be changed later on using change element parameter local axis. Let us talk about soil structure interaction simulation. We can now export our Gen model to GTS NX, which is our geotechnical software. Now GTS NX gives the accurate soil stiffness based on soil properties assigned and substructure modeled in GTS NX. These results can be imported back to MIDAS Gen to accurately simulate the soil stiffnesses offered. Let me open a model file to discuss this idea in detail. This is a building created in Gen in which only fixed supports at the bottom nodes have been provided and no soils is simulated right now. So what we can do is we can directly import this model to GTS NX, which I have done right now. I have created this substructure portion, applied soil properties to this, found out what is the stiffness offered by the soil to the substructure of this building, and those results can now be imported in Gen by directly importing your nodal results for GTS NX. So let me import those results and just see right now we have only fixed supports. When I import these results, the software offers us stiffness in terms of multilinear links provided by the soil. Okay, so we can check out these multilinear springs. These are all the locations where soil stiffness has been simulated and this is a sample force deformation function for the stiffness offered by the soil. Okay, let us check out the next update. So apart from the point spring supports, surface springs can also be now applied to an area by providing distributed springs. Concrete damaged plastic model offers us different stress strain graph for tension as well as compression. So you can see the analysis results of the model with cyclic loading for concrete plastic damaged model. Let us now jump into shell design as per Eurocode. See, the design of reinforcement for concrete shells is done in accordance with a predetermined field of moments based on provisions of Eurocode 2, 1992-2004. The idea would be more clear when we refer to a sample file. So, this is a model file in which some of these elements have been assigned as shell and assigned under a subdomain. Let us see the design report for these shell elements. So I have to first analyze the model file for all the loads that have been applied and various load combinations have already been created in the model. Once that has been done, I can check out the load combinations over here. So under concrete tab, these are the combinations created. Now if I design for shell, I have three options. Either I can go for shell flexural design or checking or shell shear checking. When I go for flexural design checking, for rebar direction 1. Okay, I click on apply and the software will now provide us the membrane axial forces obtained in these shell elements, and these are the results. Okay, so I had only applied these 6 elements right now to reduce the time taken for analysis and design. We can check out these are the membrane forces obtained in these shells. Then same goes for shear forces. What about the reinforcement required? So you can check out these are the reinforcement required in terms of mm square per meter for these shell elements for this particular model. Okay, so to conclude, you can see for rebar I have these many result options. For concrete I have principal, composite stress, compressive stress and your ratio. Okay, let us go back to the presentation. So this was the idea for shell shear check. Let us understand the concept of shell design in brief. See, generally shell elements are subjected to 8 stress resultants. Now these are 3 membrane force components, 2 flexural moment components and 1 twisting moments. So 3 forces, 3 moments and 2 transverse shear force components. Now for the purpose of design, the shell is conceived as comprising 2 outer layers centered on the mid planes of the outer reinforcement layers, and we have an uncracked core in between. Now this is sometimes called a sandwich model. The covers of the sandwich model, that is the outer layers, they are assumed to carry your moments and the membrane forces, while the transverse shear forces are assigned to the core as shown in this image. Sandwich model is assumed only when we have a cracked section. Okay, so we had already shown you the results obtained. Default value for the top and bottom layer in the sandwich model is taken as 0.2 times H, and Midas-Gen also offers iteration to calculate the layer thickness automatically. Let us refer to this again in the model file. So while creating my design code, I have already assigned the concept of shell design. So let me just check out the results again for shell flexural design. And this time I'll check out the results for rebar AS required. Okay. So if I check out the AS required for rebar and let me generate a detailed report in the text file. Okay. So you can clearly see this is the text file report that has been created. Over here you can see whether the concrete is cracked or uncracked. If it is uncracked, no reinforcement is provided. If it is cracked, then software provides a reinforcement. So for elements which are cracked, the sandwich model should be used as clearly shown in the design report. Coming back to the presentation, so that was about the shell design that has been incorporated now. Again, this is the procedure shown for shell design in detail. These are some other technical information. Okay, now let us talk about the next update. So now the drop panel and column capital can be assigned at your column and flat slab connection. Okay, so this slide shows you how to model a slab by using auto mesh function. Okay, Let us now check out the next update regarding construction stage analysis. So earlier we had the option of analysis by carrying out linear or non-linear analysis. Now we have also incorporated material non-linearity in construction stage analysis. Okay, coming to the reinforcement data, the rebar data provided in GEN can now be linked to the general section designer GSD by making it easy to provide the reinforcements in GSD, okay, and thus generating better interaction curve and moment curvature curve in GSD itself. Strain results can now be obtained for plastic materials for the Tresca model, von Mises, Mohr, Coulomb, Drucker, Prager and concrete damage model. Moreover, damage ratios for compression and tension as well as the stress strain curve as talked about earlier for concrete damage model can be provided separately. Okay, this is again the same idea for the total strain in the concrete damage model as talked about earlier. Let us now see a transmission tower wizard which has been incorporated in GEN, which allows you to model your tower very easily. Okay, so this is the tower that was created in GEN. Let me show you how easily I can create this tower. So I'm going to delete this entire model file, okay, and I can even delete the section file, sections created. So let me just delete all the sections over here. So I go to properties, section properties, and I'm going to select all of these sections and delete it. Okay. See, for that I go to structure, I go to tower wizard, and I first apply, create my tower leg. So you can provide the information over here, click on apply, and this creates a leg for you, tower leg. After this, I am going to now create a tower body. Okay, so these are the dimensions that I have to provide. I am going to provide this in the vertical direction. So let's say I create total 8 layers, and now I have to assign my insertion point for the transmission tower. So I'm going to assign this as my insertion point. Okay, depending upon the origin point provided earlier, I click on apply, and you can see that your body of the tower has been created. Now I'm going to complete this tower by providing a tower leg. So this is the, sorry, not the tower leg, my bad, the tower arm. Okay, so this is the information for the tower arm. I leave rest as it is. This dimension was earlier provided 6000, so I have changed that. And insertion point I am going to again provide depending upon the origin point for this member. Okay, and I click on apply, and you can see that this tower has been created. So this was a very simple tower. You can create various kinds of complicated towers by checking out various options that has been offered to you. For example, you can choose these are the options for front and these are the options for plane in tower leg. Moreover, for tower body, you have options for choosing horizontal variation. These are the three variations in horizontal, and these are the variations for the what? The horizontal direction. Okay, so you can choose as many variations as you want. That finishes this idea of transmission tower. Let us go back to the model file and the presentation. Okay. Next, let me talk about torsional irregularity. So depending upon the story drift, torsional irregularity check is now performed for regular, irregular and extreme irregularity. Wind pressure can now be applied to any area, be it straight or curved, as you can see in this image, or any such variation by assigning a loading area in a group. Okay, wind pressure can be applied on a loading area by defining a user defined pressure function. Let me open a model file to explain this idea in detail. So I have this plant structure. In this plant structure, suppose I want to assign wind to this side, which is the windward side. Okay, so I can assign, create a user defined wind function. So I go to load tab, I go to wind pressure function, and now I can create my own function. So suppose I name my function as wind 1. Okay, you can decide your equation. So suppose my equation is 0.5 h square. Okay, that is the depth square. So yeah, and you can choose this as your increment. I click on calculate, and you can see depending, this height has already been picked by the software depending upon the extreme point. This is the wind function which has been created by the software. Once this wind function has been created, now I can assign a loading area. So to do that, I just have to, let me show you the loading area which has already been created. You just have to select these nodes to create this loading area. Once that has been done, now I can assign a wind pressure function by choosing my loading area and my function and click on apply. Okay, and now you can see this is the wind pressure depending upon the user defined function that was created in Midas Gen. Same functions can be created for leeward side as well as for y direction as well. Okay, going back to the next update. Soil being non-linear, it offers different stiffness based on its deformation. So such force deformation function for my multilinear springs and point spring stiffness can be directly imported from GTS NX, as was already talked about earlier. Okay, so this was this force deformation function. So earlier this function was also defined using six coordinates. Okay, in the latest version, in the later versions, we have updated it to define FD curve with as many coordinates as required for an accurate curve. Okay, we have incorporated a tank wizard in Midas Gen to mostly focus on sloshing effect. See, whenever water tanks, okay, apply brakes, water slosh force acts on the sides of the tank walls, right? So this sloshing effect can be simulated using springs in Midas Gen Wizard easily. Let me open a file in which I can do that. So I go to structure, I go to tank wizard over here. You can see these are the springs provided to simulate your sloshing effect. Okay, so you can just refer to this guide diagram, provide some values over here. So suppose I leave these as it is, and I decide my number of general links as 8, and I make this also as 8. Okay, and I click on OK. So I have to assign some material and thickness properties. I click on OK. You can see this tank has been created, and all of these general links, okay, simulate your sloshing effect in the tanks. Why are three springs shown over here? Because when I had created a tank, I had provided my number of mass as 3. The more number of masses you have, more number of springs can be simulated to consider the sloshing effect directly using my tank wizard in Midas Gen. Okay, let us go back to the presentation. As I had already talked about the drop panel, it can also be modeled at the bottom of the column to act as pedestal. Slab flexural checking as well as shell flexural checking offers the details about the reinforcements used in shell. Okay, so you can directly use reinforcement results in Midas Gen. Okay, next let me talk about slab design. So in the latest version, rebar, in the earlier versions actually, rebar data after the design was updated only for elements. So each element can have a different rebar data. However, generally the engineers apply same rebar data in some of those elements, right? So for that we have incorporated subdomain where the software provides same rebar data for every subdomain created. So you can refer to this, these are the subdomains created and accordingly same rebar data has been provided to all of these subdomains. The graphic report of column has also been improved. So in the latest version, in the earlier versions actually, the shear result was provided without the distinction of axis. In the latest version, we can see the shear results in each direction. Bilinear springs can be added in surface spring supports to simulate the strength limit of the soil. Coming to force and stress contours. So forces and stresses for plate elements earlier could only be obtained at the nodes, which now can also be obtained at the center of the plate elements. Okay, we have incorporated this node icon finally in the toolbar, so we can control easily the display off and on nodes. So right, this is a display off, so you cannot see the node position with on. Just by clicking on this, now you can check out the node positions. PM interaction curve has also been improved. So earlier this curve was based on M by P ratio constant method, which is one of the most common methods available. Now we can generate the curve by keeping P constant. Seismic design by this method is supported. Beam column joint design during ductile design as per Eurocode 2 and NTC 2018 has also been improved. So now the hoop rebar area and spacing can be checked in joint design. Let me show you a model file for that. So suppose I have this model file. In this, seismic analysis has been carried out. So I have provided my design code such that in the seismic design parameter I have provided for beam column joint design as well as for confined joint as well as non-confined joint. National annexure Italy or recommended can be provided and NTC 2018 is provided. Once this is done, now if you want to go for joint design, so let me just carry out ductile design. Okay, we can directly check out the joint design results even in the graphical form. So if you see, you can either see check spacing, what it means when you have check spacing for joint. Let me show you in the presentation. So if you have this kind of check spacing, it means that your shear use is less than your shear minimum. Okay, which means it is okay. So as I said, the hoop rebar as well as spacing and joint design has been improved, and for both confined joint as well as non-confined joint. So now this option has been incorporated, and even in the design reports the joint design is calculated in detail. Wind pressure function has been improved, we already talked about this. One more information to let you know. So if you want to now edit wind pressure function even directly in the tabular results, these are directly reflected in the values obtained over here. Okay, beam and offset can be applied providing different values along the axis. Coming to the earth pressure function, so these earth pressure function, this was available earlier as well, but now it reflects the values edited in the table. So you can directly provide your soil pressure and this is directly reflected now in terms of this graphical representation. Okay, finally in 2021 version we have provided the facility to simulate debonded tendons easily in MIDAS Gen. You just have to provide debonded length for the pre-tensioned tendon and accordingly the results, the effect of debonding is reflected in the results. Finally, the last update in MIDAS Gen, we have provided a Revit 2021 interface as well as a Tekla interface for MIDAS Gen. So if you see, this is the Revit software. Over here I have this external tool wherein you can directly send the model to MIDAS Gen or you can import the model from Gen to Revit. Okay, in the form of MGT file, and these are all the functions which can be imported from Gen to Revit, back from Revit to Gen, and these are the functions which can be imported from Revit to Gen, but not vice versa. Okay, so you can refer to these. We have provided Revit 2021 interface as well. That finishes my updates in MIDAS Gen. Let us now jump to Design Plus updates. Okay, so Design Plus offers efficient design of various building components such as beams, columns, staircase, steel connections, slabs, basement walls, footings, etc. Also, after obtaining the design results, engineer can obtain AutoCAD drawings for these designed items. As I talked about a moment ago, you can see these all components can be designed easily using MIDAS Design Plus. If I talk about the updates, the graphical user interface has now been updated for Design Plus to display various windows without changing the screen resolution. Moreover, some intuitive icons have been added and arranged in tabs in order to provide easy design to the user. Okay, steel design earlier was available for H shape. Now we have it for H shape, T shape, angle, channel, box, pipe, solid round and solid box section. Let me open a model file to explain this idea better about Design Plus. Okay, yeah, so this is a model file created. Now over here we already have the facility of Design Plus provided, so I just have to open that. Yeah, once we open it, the first thing we can do is, if you want to directly link your Gen and Design Plus software, you have this option of MIDAS link. You can select that file and it links the Gen file to MIDAS Design Plus. Okay, so now suppose you select this element. Okay, if you select this element, this is a beam element which I have selected. You can see it gets reflected over here. I click on import and now this beam has been imported. So these are the dimensions for the beams. You can define your forces. So suppose I define my forces over here. Once that has been done, you can easily generate the detailed report. Okay, I'll show you the report in a bit. Let me we talk about the steel options available. So if I go for steel, you can see first I have to decide what kind of a member I want. Suppose I want a beam member, okay, for my steel. Now you can, I'll just show you the member list which I have, okay. So under steel you can decide your beam column, you can define base plate, bolted connection, crane girder, purlin, web opening, okay. And as I had said earlier, we only had H section, now we have T section, angle, channel, box, pipe and solid round and solid box. Coming back to the PPT. Okay. See, RC beam and column designed by Eurocode is now supported by Design Plus. Also the national annexure as recommended based on the nationally determined parameters and or Italy are supported. Both ULS as well as SLS checks can be performed in Design Plus. Coming to serviceability limit states, K1, K2 and K3 factors are found in national annex or even user defined values to ensure the stress limitation in concrete. These can be provided in Design Plus. Second order effects is considered if the slenderness ratio defined exceeds the limiting slenderness ratio in X and Y direction. We have the option of shear connection, including, so earlier we had actually a bolt connection which had the option of single shear as well as double shear bolted connection. Okay, let me just open a Midas Design Plus model. So if I go for checking out the options available for bolted connection, see, earlier we just had bolt connection, and in bolt connection you could define it for, just a moment, let me open it again. Yeah, you can see we had this option of single shear and double shear for bolt. Now we also have a moment resisting joint. Okay, so now your bolted connections can even have moment resisting joint as per Eurocode 1993-2005 version. Okay, going back to the PPT, Midas link between Gen and Design Plus allows us to import all the required elements easily. Base plate design based on the effective area method or your finite element method are now supported as per Eurocode 1993-2005 version. So effective area method can have H shaped section, and your finite element model can have H shape, box shape, pipe section, etc. for the base plates. This is regarding the default registry which has been updated according to user's convenience. See, this feature is common for all the software in Midas. Most of the tabular results are Excel compatible and they offer easily editing and export from Midas to Excel, which can be copy pasted back to Midas softwares. Okay, so it offers very easily changing values. You can see this is the report in terms of Excel format. So you can have report either in terms of Excel or Word format. I have already generated a Word format for you, which I'm going to show you in a bit. Let me just show you the word format for RC members. Okay, so this is a simple report that was generated in MS Word for a member designed in Design Plus. Okay, if I show you for the plate, the steel connection, again this is the report generated for my steel member. Okay, you can see various checks have been performed to decide whether the section and the is sufficient to take the load or not. Okay, also all of these load combinations created in Midas Gen could now be imported easily in Design Plus to provide most critical design results for the worst possible combination. This is the linking option, as I had already talked about a bit ago. You can see this is again talking about the linking option. So we can directly import all combinations, or you can select whichever combination you want to import, and accordingly thus Midas Design Plus software designs those elements. Usually we suggest to directly go for all combinations to get most critical results. Okay, apart from isolated footing and strip footing, now even combined footing, that is the mat footing design, is also supported in Midas Engine based on Eurocode 2 2004. Okay, so you can see we have this facility of combined footing now, which can be designed in Midas Gen Design Plus. Okay, this is a procedure which is shown for combined footing design. So you can see they have defined the sections, loading, column information, and rebar arrangement can be provided if you want to check whether the footing is sufficient to take all the loads or not. Combined footing design report can also be generated as per Eurocode. Okay, so these were some of the updates available. Finally, coming to the last update in Midas Design Plus. A few moments ago, I had shown you a report generated in Word file, okay, in Midas Design Plus. Earlier, you can see in 2020 version, the report which took roughly 28 to 30 seconds to generate, in 21 version, it can be generated in fractions of seconds. And these reports are very detailed and can be directly submitted to the client. Okay, so these were the updates available in Midas Gen and Design Plus. I hope you understood all of those updates. A very quick introduction to Midas Engine software that we'll take up now. Okay, so let me open the Midas Engine model file. So earlier we had talked about Midas Gen and Design Plus. Both of this design, Midas Gen, this was based on modeling based on node element method. Okay, we have now created another software called Midas Design Plus, in which modeling can be done not based on node element method, but rather based on your object oriented modeling. Okay, so this object oriented modeling reduces your modeling time, and it offers various other facilities, which let us go into the details now. Okay, so as I said, now we'll talk about Midas Engine, our next generation solution for building analysis and design. See, Midas already had the technology for computer aided design as well as computer aided engineering. Also, we had graphical user interface available and object-oriented modeling was available. Now, Engine is a product created by fusion of all of these technologies. Okay, so Engine is a next generation software that provides total solution through the fusion of CAD for drawing, BIM generation technology for creating results, and CAE technology for the modeling analysis and design. Okay, let us check out the main features of Midas Engine now. As mentioned earlier, through the easy CAD based modeling, automation of load, fast and accurate analysis, optimal design, and finally automatic output generation, we can complete the design process very, very quickly in Midas Engine. And it is also possible to design RC and steel building plant structures as well as irregular steel structures as shown on the screen over here. Now we have created various member objects such as beam, column, walls, slabs, mat, flat slabs, basement walls, etc., which allows for easily modeling and design. This is a CAD based modeling video, so modeling using CAD tools like translate, copy, extrude, extend, trim, offset, etc., makes it very easy to model in Midas Engine, and people who are already comfortable with AutoCAD would find modeling very easy. Okay, so this video showed some of the tools for the CAD based modeling. And it is also possible to do the modeling based on your grid line or CAT tracing. So in case of CAT tracing or grid tracing, Engine recognizes the member and carries out the analysis and design. Next, we have auto generation of meshed model. You can see over here, this is one of the most powerful features in Engine. So we begin just by creating a simple body shape, okay? And as is shown in this video, we can automatically mesh it. Even the mesh can be created very finer, and when changing the model shape, it is no longer necessary to modify the existing mesh again like some other softwares. Okay, then it is also possible to easily set the member offset and perform analysis using offset information and support the creation of drawings including offset in Midas Engine. You can see we have something called an auto mesh feature where we can model any irregular or regular shaped structures, curved walls, shells, domes, and it can be analyzed easily in Engine. For cross sectional shape, as shown in this page, Engine supports various cross sections and composite sections for RC and steel. Let me open an Engine model file so that we can check out some modeling. See, this was a model created first in Gen, which was imported in Engine. You can clearly see this is an object oriented modeling. So right now none of these plate elements have been meshed by default. Once we analyze it, these can be meshed easily. Just check out the various members you have to carry out the design of these. So you can have beams, columns, braces, sub beam, sub column, walls, slabs, plate elements, flat slab. Then for basement you have pedestal, footing girder, basement walls, isolated footing, strip and mat footing. All of these can be designed in Midas Engine. We have various CAD tools available which I talked about some time ago. Coming back to the presentation, DXF or DWG files from AutoCAD can be imported easily in Midas engine as well. So you can see we have this option of importing DXF and DWG, both 2D and 3D model in Midas engine. These can be traced easily to generate the entire modeling very easy. See, multi-tower structure having a mat foundation can be modeled having a common diaphragm for basement layers and separate diaphragm for towers. Moreover, the wind and seismic loading based on code provisions has been automated. So any manual calculation of wind and seismic load need not be done, making it very easy to apply them. If I show you the same in the model, so you see under load tab, I have this option of wind loading based on the wind load functions, which can be directly picked from code as well. Same goes for seismic analysis as well. Next, most of the skeletal features can be modeled. We can model and detail beams with different position. Okay, you can see the beams are with different position. A column tangent to the beams at different locations, and a beam tangent to slabs at different levels. Okay, for this we have something called a plate beam and plate column in Midas engine. Engine also offers us various loads for users to define the load variation. For example, we have something called floor load or slab load, which allows you to apply multiple loadings like dead load, SIDL, live load in one go by grouping them under the slab and the floor load. Wind load, as I said a few moments ago, can be now generated based on the various codal provisions, and they could be applied to the model. So automatic wind load input and wind automatic load correction based on the modeling changes are also possible. In case of seismic analysis, static seismic load and response spectrum are easily generated in engine. Imperfection to the loads and the initial sway coefficient can also be applied. Basically, model analysis, P delta analysis, buckling analysis are available. As a special analysis, functions and direct design methods for crane can be added. Now, in the future, construction stage analysis, pushover, and time history analysis would also be added to engine to grow it into a more powerful program. Just check out this auto meshing based on smart 3-noded or 4-noded elements for plate and 4-noded or 6-noded for my solid elements can be generated easily, giving more accurate analysis in engine. And as I talked about this being an object oriented model, we first model it and later on mesh it by providing some mesh size control to the user, to the software. Now, auto meshing based on 3-noded and 4-noded, we already talked about that, which will give you more accurate results. Now, above are the codes available for the design. So we have now also incorporated Polish National Annex and the design report based on the Polish code. Slabs such as one-way slab and two-way slabs, moreover flat slabs design is available. Also, as I said, mat footing, strip footing and isolated footing can be designed in engine. The software automatically calculates the amount of reinforcement based on the analysis member forces and the code provisions. Now in the future we are also going to develop a function to find an optimized cross section for RC and steel. Okay, so we are generating the section properties right now. Now when designing is finished, we can check the design level of each part according to the target ratio provided graphically. Can be checked graphically. So the target design ratio can be set in the design setting dialog box. If you check out the screens, four categories are available. One is need check, okay, critical and not good NG. Okay means that we are within the minimum and the maximum target ratios. Critical means the ratio is between maximum and 1. NG means not good means the design by capacity ratio is greater than 1. Thus such members needs to be redesigned by improving the member. Need check is displayed for members for which we have a ratio smaller than the minimum target design ratio. So for such members they are over safe and they need to be optimized more. For design results, tabular results, summary results and detailed results are available. You can see this is the summary result and the detailed result as well as the tabular result over here. Moreover, reports also provides you with sub clause number. So people who are not very much aware about the CODEL provisions used to design my members can easily refer to this, and these reports can also be directly submitted to the client. For plant structure design based on crane load as moving load is possible. Now crane can be defined by inputting wheel load or directly going for crane specifications. So this talks about the details when going for crane modeling as moving loads. Pipe racks that are designed to support pipes, power cables and instrument cable trays can also be modeled easily. 3D shapes using CAD tools like extrude, revolve, sweep and loft allows quick modeling. As I said, 3D shapes like extrude, revolve, sweep and loft is going to provide you the modeling which can be done very easy. Midas engine offers an interface between engine and SAP, StadPro, Midas Gen, Parasolid files etc. Thus they can be imported easily in Midas engine. Coming to the output generation, we have developed auto generator for the calculation report as shown above. See, the dynamic report generator supports the customization of report, and dynamic updation of report is possible when changing the model or design easily. Structural drawing can be directly generated using Midas engine. Rebar drawing generation is provided by Midas drawing, which comes as a subset of Midas engine software. Bill of quantities again can be generated very easily. And moreover, if I talk about customer support, Midas is known for its robust and quick customer support. We provide video and PDF tutorials and also customize the trainings depending upon the client projects. Our online query support provides prompt resolution of the queries. Let me open some of the sample model files to show you the kind of structures which can be quickly generated in Midas engine. Okay, so this is one such model file that you can see on your screen. Let me generate some other model files. This is a RC bungalow which has been generated in Midas engine. This was a very simple bungalow that was generated in Midas Gen. Coming to some other structures, for example, school building, elevated water tank, aeration tank, banners, chimneys, etc., can also be modeled very easily. If I talk about some complicated structures, for example, stupa or buildings. So this is a water tank that was generated in Midas Gen. This is a stupa building. Just check out how detailed modeling has been done, and all of these structural components can be easily designed and their reports can be generated in Midas engine. Going back to the presentation and talking about some of the other project applications. So these are some of the informal buildings. Does anyone know this building? This is a building called the Turning Torso, designed by Calatrava, and this was he was revered as the best architect after Antonio Gaudi. So you can see this was modeled, this as a sample was modeled in Midas engine in less than an hour. This is again an irregular building. So you can see even such atypical structures having curved structures and platforms can be modeled and designed easily in Midas engine. Coming to multi towers having same support and different towers can be modeled. Moreover, the analysis of all these towers for wind load and various static loads and time history loads can be performed in over here. Also, various complex structures can be modeled and designed in Midas Gen. That was for reinforced for the RC structures. Moreover, we also have the facility for steel structures, various plant structures, refinery. Such kinds of silos can be modeled. So as I had talked about engine being a fine object based modeling, wherein the objects are modeled first and then meshed later on automatically. So users are able to model and analyze various kinds of shapes with very less effort. This is a kind of ball tank which can be created. Foundations for silos or various plants and tanks can be modeled. Shell member, for example, for cooling tower. These structures may look complicated, but actually it was modeled in less than a minute in Midas engine. Such kinds of stadiums, pylon towers, steel bridge, various RC structures, for example tunneling or box culvert. Your bridges can be modeled as well in Midas engine. See, this is a structure, an office building performed in South Korea. So over here seismic design was performed and the domestic code was applied for load and design code. This is a practical example of a model created in Midas engine. Another example again for engine which was created. This is a building structure. So these are now some of the practical examples. This model was created in South Africa. These are the types of analysis that was performed, and it had in total 4 towers. Static and response spectrum analysis was carried out for seismic loading. A villa kind of structure done in South Korea, again including your various seismic loadings, and your lateral resistance system was a shear wall and frame interaction system. A kind of building structure generated. This is some kind of various plant structures having sheds and roofs modeled as shell elements in Midas engine. Another hotel structure that was created in Poland, wherein the analysis was carried out using Eurocode 2 as well as the design. A kind of irregular building structure generated in engine, again in Poland. This is a building structure where snow load was also applied in Poland. Same goes for irregular slabs which can be modeled. You can refer to this kind of a plate member structures for buildings. Then this is a shed or a plant based on steel members. That is a gable frame structure that this was generated in Indonesia using Midas engine. Another plant engineering structure generated in South Korea. This is basically a pipe rack system where Midas engine was used. Coming to again a plant engineering structure where wind load was applied using ASC 7-2010 code. A water treatment structure generated in South Korea. So such kinds of treatment tanks can be modeled easily. Again a plant structure generated. This is a kind of coal shed which was generated in Midas gen. You can see it has such kinds of huge mat foundations as well as having various pile supports as well. These are some of the plant structures generated. Again some sample model files, various plant structures. Yeah, so that finishes some of the modeling and analysis and design which could be easily carried out in Midas engine. Basically the difference between Gen and Engine was Gen being a node element based software, Engine is a object oriented modeling. So that finishes the webinar for the day. I hope you all enjoyed the updates in Gen and Design Plus and a quick introduction to Midas Design Plus. Midas Engine, sorry. Thank you all for joining. Have a good day. Bye-bye.